That's going to be what they're going for. Method Black had plenty of time to prepare their answer. And now that you've seen it, who do you think's going to take it, Grmbl or Method Black?
I'm a little bit disappointed. I just wanted to see Jim play with Volkovich and Voltarius again. They've been competing together since Mists of Pandaria as the same composition for years. They're definitely masters of it. But of course, you need to diversify if you want to go all the way. So they picked up Xynthius as their fourth member, who is playing the Mistweaver, a secondary healer for this team to try and add some X factor. And the Mistweaver is definitely a stronger pick in the current meta, especially late into dampening, adding in that Way of the Crane for an extra hit. You can see currently Grmbl, they're focused. They want to take this out for the late game. They know if they go into center field, as they're trying to do now, they're more than likely going to overextend themselves. And if they overextend themselves, they take a ton of damage like right now and almost end up dying in a couple of milliseconds. So Grmbl need to stay at the pillar, wait for Method Black to move in before they can continue to counterattack or use Death Grip, as we saw Raikou pulled in, but Raikou had immediate reactions to that and blinked back into center field. Currently, two members of Grmbl chasing down Raikou, but Chaz is easily denying it with some well-timed heals that innervate excellently placed, making all of his healing free. We do see Swapsy pushing up a bit aggressive here. I'm wondering what he's looking to get done.
Yep, and we can see Voltarix now at the pillar right now. And actually, I was looking at some of the talent choices for Voltarix in this matchup. He's playing some of the more offensive talents, so he's actually going in with Tiger Eye Brew as well as Alpha Tiger. So it doesn't have the Fortifying Brew, really showing that I think what he wants to do in this matchup is take down a high armor target with that Tiger Eye Brew, which is eventually going to be an all-in for Swapsy.
And also, throughout the entirety of the tournament, if you want to check in on any of the builds that the players have gone for gear-wise, talent-wise, you can do that with the extension. It is back. It is powered by Wowhead, and you can actually check it out throughout the day and see what the players are up to.
Oh, currently a pretty big exchange of cooldowns between Grmbl and Method Black. Voltarius taking the bad end of that exchange, although still trying to get aggressive towards Raikou. We see Xynthius in center field looking to set up some crowd control to Chaz, but he exposed himself, now having to use his Gladiator's Medallion and not even securing crowd control onto Chaz. Xynthius makes a trade for nothing, falling even further behind against Method Black in game one.
Yeah, Volkovich Voltarix really just focusing on taking down Raikou, slowing down his damage as much as possible. And that's often what we see from these cleave setups. The Frost Mage can be devastating if he's allowed to just throw out as many blizzards as possible, as many frost bolts as possible. It's sort of loading him up to do massive amounts of burst. And if you can sit on him and deny a lot of that damage, then the Frost Mage capabilities offensively does get greatly limited. So that is what Volkovich and Voltarix's main objective is in this match. And like I said, with the talent choices Voltarix has to him, I think eventually what's going to happen is they're going to pick a moment in the game to sort of try an all-in Swapsy, and Chaz might not be able to handle it. And if we look at mana, Chaz is actually a little bit behind. So as long as Grmbl can keep this pressure up, this split pressure, and they can slow down some of the drinks from Chaz, this is a good strategy potentially from them.
You can see Xynthius and Chaz playing a game of cat and mouse. Xynthius is going to be the aggressive playmaker for the team in terms of crowd control, but Chaz is smartly positioning himself. So if Xynthius wants to get in range to crowd control, he exposes himself to crowd control himself, and Swapsy has completely capitalized on that with well-timed hexes, now a counterspell as well. This does force Voltarius to trade powerful defensive cooldowns, such as the Touch of Karma, which will now not be available for another minute and 16 seconds, a quite potent cooldown to survive. Although in the meantime, Method Black are finally starting to get pressured by Grmbl. This is a Way of the Crane push from Xynthius, but sitting through Polymorph, he gets denied on it. Good denial by Raikou.
Yeah, definitely an excellent job. Now sitting in his Blizzard, Xynthius pushing in, trying to slow down Chaz, who is looking for drinks in this matchup. Volkovich is going to be turning his attention over at Raikou, making his way over there, looking for some damage. Voltarix actually reasonably vulnerable in this situation. He doesn't have a single defensive cooldown left. Luckily for him, Xynthius does have his Trinket coming back up, Life Cocoon available, so he should be fine, but definitely something to consider for Grmbl as they make an offensive push onto both Raikou and Swapsy.
Well-timed Temporal Shield. Raikou with great defense here in game one. Swapsy with great offense, setting up crowd control for his team, securing many full hexes onto Xynthius. It's very important when you're playing a composition such as Method Black's with a Mage and an Elemental Shaman, so two ranged classes. Raikou is the one being attacked. It's going to be very difficult for him to get crowd control control onto the enemy healer. So it swaps his job instead to be trying to get crowd control onto Xynthius. Raikou's main objective is to stay alive and pull Voltarius and Vukovic in a position where Xynthius has to overextend the heal, which then enables Swapsy to get crowd control. So it's important to have good teamwork as the double spellcaster. And if you're the one being attacked, such as Raikou in this position, focus on defense, dragging Voltarius and Vukovic out into the far corner. So now Xynthius is overextended in his position, and now he's more exposed to Swapsy moving forward. But obviously, while he's making these pushes, you are going to be under heavy fire, and it's up to Xynthius to find these windows of opportunity to sneak in and get damage out while still being able to avoid crowd control.
Yeah, I think that's definitely a reasonable assessment of the situation. Swapsy needs to be looking for some hexes onto Xynthius, and he's been doing a good job with that so far in this matchup. Like you said, Raikou really just focusing on surviving, putting out as much pressure as he can, kiting around Voltairex and Vukovic, avoiding damage with his Novas, with his Blizzard, with his Frost Bolts. All those Frost Mage snares are going to be vital in this matchup. Now a double leg sweep coming in from Voltairex. Decent pressure here for him onto Raikou and Swapsy, but should be okay. Swapsy trinkets out. He's going to be avoiding most of that cleave damage and actually manages to find another hex here onto Xynthius. And I'm kind of surprised. Xynthius, he got hexed and he just sat there. He could have ran into the frozen orb, into the blizzard, potentially broke that a lot sooner, but you opted just to stand still. Potentially a little bit of a misplay there. Like to see Xynthius try to at least break those hexes, because eventually they do break on damage.
We've seen throughout the cups that the best target, currently a lot of damage under Raikou as we just step into Dampany. If they can get ice blocks here, it would be critical moving forward for the rest of the match, but unable to find enough damage to do so. As I was about to say, when playing against these Death Knight compositions, we see a lot of the tournament teams choose to just completely ignore the Death Knight before dampening. They're far too durable and unlikely to go down. So instead, they focus their pressure either on the healer, so currently Swapsy is attacking Xynthius, or onto the other DPS member, in this case, Voltarius. And I think that's an important strategy adaptation teams have made due to the tankiness of Death Knights, is you don't want to target them before dampening, you just want to crowd control and avoid them. Then deeper into dampening, you want to make a target switch and go after them. So Method Black are employing that strategy. Whenever Xynthius exposes himself in midfield, Swapsy is actually focusing a lot more damage instead of crowd control. This may be an attempt on his part to run Xynthius out of mana faster. Chaz is still actually behind in that regard, and Grmbl may be looking good to take game number one, especially if they can set up that swap onto Swapsy moving into dampening. Raikou in the meantime secures crowd control with a well-timed polymorph lightning lasso that pulls a life cocoon from the team of Grmbl, an important defensive cooldown here to be forced by Method Black. They're definitely ahead on cooldowns, but they are falling behind on mana. They need to set up Chaz for a drink, but Raikou's under fire. A race against the clock, that temporal shield seconds away from blasting him back to full health. Raikou with perfect temporal timings here in this match, now setting up cross crowd control. Hex on Xynthius, polymorph on Vukovic. It's a 3-on-1. Voltarius doesn't have much left. He's forced to portal back behind the pillar in desperation to stay alive, but they pull Xynthia's Gladiator's Medallion. Now if they can set up that situation again within a 19-second window of time, Voltarius will be an exposed target.
Yeah, definitely, and he's still in a lot of trouble. A nice interrupt there from Raikou, landing a counterspell onto Xynthius. Voltairex looking to go aggressive with his Touch of Death, but this is a risky maneuver with no Touch of Karma for another 5 seconds. Anti-Magic Zone is going to be traded out to keep Voltairex alive. He has to stand in that purple shield as it does reduced magic damage, making him very tanky against Raikou and Swapsy. But once that fades, luckily Voltairex bought enough time to get his Touch of Karma, but he's still not out of the woods. They're just shredding through this Touch of Karma with a Cyclone onto Xynthius. Lightning Lasso. Voltairex has to trinket. Way too over-aggressive there from Grmbl. Method Black easily able to punish and close out game number one.
But we definitely do see Grmbl
be the most potent one, and if you have not faced a Marksmanship Hunter, you can easily die in the opener. That is the scariest start point in the match, so I want to see if he can get a powerful opener.
Well, Grmbl has captivated the minds of everybody watching right now, breaking out the Marks Hunter for the first time that we have seen this year. 50% of you think it's going to be enough for them to take down Method Black.
Well, I'm definitely curious to see Xynthius now in a polymorph. Voltairex already in a lot of trouble.
What?
Gets down to 10% HP into the aspect of the turtle. And this is one of the problems. As a Marksmanship Hunter, he could just die right now in the open. You know, manages to find a seal. But this is the problem with the Marksmanship Hunter. You're just forced to play so defensive. Mistweaver Monks are so susceptible to crowd control. Grmbl's traded out every single defensive they have. Xynthius gets locked out, forced to use Way of the Crane. This is literally a nightmare situation for Grmbl.
And Raikou is stopping all of this damage with Temporal Shield. Just every single ability activated by Grmbl soaked up with one spell trade on Raikou's part. So that puts Method Black massively ahead. Now Voltarius is going to have to play defensive here at the corner of the room, as I was expecting. No, he's trying to make a push. This is a risky decision. No defensive cooldowns for Voltarius to survive another attack. Stormkeeper is almost available for swap, so it's going to be huge lightning bolt damage. They are finally getting a little bit of counter pressure, but that lightning lasso, good line of sighting by Swapsy to avoid interrupts. Raikou secures a polymorph, and Voltarius could easily fall here. He's on the run, ducking behind that swifty skateboard ramp, avoiding a near-death experience, and there's just no pressure on their side. He's just not going to be too useful on this marksmanship hunter so far.
Well, here's the problem. Xynthius in the last matchup, he has the flexibility. He might just go down right here, right now. Life Cocoon comes in once again from Xynthius, but like I was saying, there used to be the flexibility on their team that they had a Windwalker Monk and a Death Knight to survive. Xynthius could make these offensive pushes, but Voltarix, he can't keep himself alive like this on a marksmanship hunter. Now AMZ gets dropped out. Beautiful crowd control from Method Black. This is, like I said, this is going to be ending very early. There's a full Cyclone. Voltaire still running and hiding for his life. Frozen Orb gets dropped out. And I think it's just a matter of time before he does go down.
Oh, the Exile just came off cooldown, but it's not going to be enough. Ultimately, we are going to see the Hunter here. They have their backs completely against the wall. Method Black can send them packing here. We are in the lower portion of the bracket. The Titans, with 240 points this season, looking to crush the dreams of Grmbl.
I think historically, we've known Grmbl for aggression and running teams over really fast-paced Windwalker DK action, but in the current build and meta of the game, that is just simply not a strategy that is even available for an opportunity. So Grmbl have to shift gears. They have to change the way that they're thinking strategically and look for a later game push, especially coordinating the new PvP trinket, the Gladiator's Maledict. If they can coordinate all three of these, initiating with one, baiting Chaz to dispel its healing absorption effect, and then committing two further after that, they can force Ice Block from Raikou. If they can set that up on a two-minute cycle again, they will get the second Ice Block from Raikou, and if they can set it up a third time, they will ultimately kill Raikou deeper in dampening. And from my observation of the meta and the observations of the matches that we've seen throughout the cups, I see this as the only way for Grmbl to win.
Yeah, Grmbl could also play a mana strategy on this map. I think it's going to be really difficult for Chaz to actually sneak away and drink, and I think on this smaller map, the uptime Voltarix and Vulkovic could potentially get would be high, but it looks like they're opting to just sit back for now. Grmbl is going to be hiding behind this pillar, waiting for an opportunity. Maybe they want to grip Swapsy in. Maybe they want to grip Raikou in if he gets a little bit too close, but Raikou's doing a good job sitting back. As I say that, he gets grip, but immediately blinks away, so opportunity lost for Grmbl. Full Hex now secured onto Xynthius, but with everyone just pillaring, avoiding damage, Method Black really isn't going to be able to get too much done.
Yeah, it's going to be very difficult. We've seen teams go head-to-head like this with the Millicleaves matchup into the double caster. With the Millicleave going to midfield, they expose themselves to tons of damage, so they often are pinned at the pillar, looking for anyone to overextend into their team, at least in the early game. There's really no small victories they can gain by leaving the pillar before dampening, so it's just in their best interest to avoid the spellcasters as long as possible and hope that they get impatient or fish for a mage like this with the Death Grip pulling Raikou in, but who can now easily escape with Blink completely unscathed. I do like Swapsy and Raikou's positioning with one player on one side of the pillar and the other on the other. That way, you cannot avoid both of them at the same time. Very good positioning and execution by Method Black with this composition. You can tell that they're more than prepared. Xynthius tries to make an aggressive move here, looking for crowd control in that way of the crane to try and add some damage to his team, but completely deflected by a Hex from Swapsy. Voltarius removed from the match with a polymorph, a three-on-one situation created, which is now pulling defensive cooldowns from Vulkovic, now immediately switching back to Voltarius. Voltarius likely to be the kill target, at least before dampening, for the team of Grmbl. Method Black looking like they want to make a push here as Voltarius tried to retreat behind the pillar. See if Swapsy can close this out. Nice Ursul's Vortex on that Transcendence portal. Good, nice play by Chaz, but ultimately not going to be netting them any significant advantages.
Yeah, Vulkovic was just sitting on Raikou that entire time, so unfortunately he wasn't able to push in and actually get some damage out. Now Voltarius leaving the pillar, now that he's topped off, to make an offensive push once again, but with that full Hex secured onto Xynthius, unfortunately was in the Frozen Orb, so it did break. That might have been an opportunity for Method Black to get some damage rolling on Voltarix, who has opted into the Fortifying Brew. So Voltarix changing his talents a little bit, and instead of going pure offense, wants to have some of that added defense of the Fortifying Brew, which makes me think that he wants to be able to sit through these exchanges. When Xynthius does get crowd controlled, he can sit in the open much longer with the Fortifying Brew and just allows him to generate more pressure for his team, which ultimately will burn the mana of Chaz, who has to activate the Iron Bark onto Raikou, who's taking a little bit of burst right now. Raikou actually behind the pillar in an unideal situation. Swapsy's not able to really back him up too much. Raikou pushing in, lands the full sheep, but with this positioning, I don't really see Method Black getting too many defensives from Grmbl.
All right, they managed to get Temporal Shield from Raikou, so I would like to see Grmbl go for a push with the Triple Maledict strategy and try and get an Ice Block just before we start to get into Dampening, although it seems to be difficult. Swapsy and Raikou's pressure is quite high, but finally connecting with the Way of the Crane. This is a perfect opportunity to just kill him, I guess. Little bit of a mistiming there on Raikou's part. They did not get control of Grmbl whatsoever. Completely disrespected the meaning of my mind with the way that this matchup plays out, is it's kind of like a tower defense game. Swapsy's team is focused on building a maze positionally for the team of Grmbl to try and run through and get as many points as they can and then get a kill onto one of the players, and that seems to be the main point of contention. If they spend too long in the maze trying to navigate to Raikou, they burn too many cooldowns and they get taken out. So it's all about finding the quickest route through the maze that Method Black are going to build for Grmbl. On Tolvaron Arena, they've got a lot of room to build a very dangerous maze, so we see Raikou and center field getting that frozen orb, so Swaps can get in there, get a little bit of damage out with the Stormkeeper, chain lightning onto three targets, well positioned, but almost entirely denied if they can't follow up with a lightning lasso. Swapsy cannot go for that stun lock unless multiple members are crowd controlled. Otherwise, somebody will prevent it and deny its damage. So Swapsy is playing it patiently and generating an important resource, Maelstrom, below his health bar, that blue bar. When it gets to full, he can then spend that on Earthshock, in this case, Earthquake, as he's hitting three members. But Earthshock is quite a devastating attack you don't want to disrespect. So keeping your eye on that bar below Swapsy's health, when it starts getting full, that's when he's a lot more dangerous.
Yeah, Swapsy is going to be very durable against his compositions. That's why you see him not really have much fear at this point of the game. He can move in if he gets gripped. He has Earthquake to knock them away. A lot of defensive cooldowns, whereas Raikou is a typical Frost Mage maneuver. You drop Blizzard on one side of the pillar. You drop Frozen Orb on the other, and that way Xynthius, Volterix, and Volkovich, they really can't avoid both. And they'll be taking damage from at least one of those abilities. If you drop your Frozen Orb and Blizzard in the same place, it's easier for them to walk away and deny a lot of that damage.
Chaz trying to jump in and save Raikou as he is pulled out of position by Volkovich. We do see Maledict activated actually by Raikou. I don't think I've seen a well-coordinated Maledict push from the team of Grmbl. They have obviously been playing together for years, but this is really the first time we've seen them come together in a cup in 2019 with that new trinket, and they definitely can coordinate it a lot better. It's very important to find victory through all the durability currently in this meta. That is one way to pierce through it. I want to see them coordinate better with them if they are going to be able to take Method Black. They have to. Otherwise, I think this is likely to be the last time we see Grmbl. So if you're a Grmbl fan, they need your energy here and now. Swapsy raining down terror, lightning lasso holding Voltarius in place, but Xynthius doing a great job to pick him up even throughout. Also doing a great job maintaining his mana despite this earthquake and blizzard harassments. Xynthius is looking unfazed.
Yep, Raikou does get gripped in once again, but still going to be fine. He is playing human, so he has the Everyman for himself. That's a racial ability that allows him to break out a stun, so he's opting into the Relentless Trinket choice, which is going to reduce all crowd control, including snares, roots, stuns on him, and I think that's a good choice for Method Black. Raikou, as the main target, is going to be able to avoid a lot of those stun durations, and when he really needs to, he has the get-out-of-jail-free card with that Everyman for himself, so that's why Raikou's opting into that. Swapsy still moving in, looking for some damage. And right now, what Method Black is doing, it may seem like it's not accomplishing too much, and it really isn't, but later on in the game, if Grmbl's not making offensive pushes, it's going to become very scary. The healing isn't going to be as easy for Xynthius, and that's when a lot of these AoE abilities like the Earthquake and the Blizzard are really going to be able to do significant damage.
Yeah, I'm curious to see at what point we see Grmbl go aggressive. Xynthius is actually not running Way of the Crane, so that big punch, that three-man pressure we saw in the last game, is not going to be available. So I expect them to play an even longer match trying to win on mana over Chaz, which is also going to be a difficult task on the largest map in the pool, where Chaz can easily just drink where he is right now in the middle of nowhere because there's so much space. But while Chaz was drinking, Grmbl are going for a push. So every time that happens, they are going to try and get a lot lot of damage. This is the Maledict attack. They managed to pull one Dispel. Now going for more Maledicts, and this is where they need to try and force an Ice Block. If they can coordinate two of those right afterwards, doesn't seem like they have it coordinated. Raikou may start to stabilize as a result. With Hex and Lightning Lasso, it's more than certain. Now, Voltarius exposed in center field, so this was the push. This was them navigating Method Black's maze, but they got denied on it, so they have to make a choice. Do we keep trying to go through to the finish, or do we run away? I don't think they have enough time to try and go through the finish, and they may not even have enough time to escape. Voltarius Transcendence portals out of line of sight. Swapsy moves in, wind shearing his heal on that Vivify. Volkovich tries to back him up by gripping Swapsy back into center field, but Voltarius is still alone behind the pillar. Swapsy is closing in around the corner, having a hard time finishing him off, but Xynthia is now in a full polymorph. Quite a dangerous situation. They've spent far too long in Method Black's maze. Ultimately, Xynthius has to trade his Gladiator's Medallion to reconnect with Voltarius and start to stabilize. So you can see already that you have to be very precise in your push. If you stay too long in the deep end, you're going to drown. You need to go in and out, in and out, in and out, weaving that aggression and defense together. Otherwise, Method Black is just going to take you down. Now Voltarius is really far behind.
Yep, there's no question about it. Raikou actually getting really low. This could be his Ice Block holding on to it with the Temporal Shield. And Chaz, during that exchange, he went for a lot of offensive Cyclones, looking for crowd control on Xynthia so Method Black could try to close out the game. And now is actually at a mana deficit compared to Xynthia. So potentially Chaz needs to look for drinks once he can stabilize Raikou and they can slow down some of this damage. But Voltarix with big uptime, keeping the pressure up onto Raikou. Nice Frost Nova coming in from Raikou as he looks for a Kona Cold, just trying to kite away and get these melee off him. But unfortunately not able to find it. And the pressure coming in from Grmbl is significant.
Yeah, Grmbl finally forcing some pressure here, as well as the important resource mana. So Chaz's blue bar below that giant orange one, that is mana. He needs that to cast healing spells. He can look to regenerate it with drinks, but if they pressure and push damage onto Raikou while he's drinking, they either have to exchange a cooldown for mana or never get mana back, and Grmbl can have them in a bit of a chokehold. And this is what Xynthius is trying to play for by not running that Way of the Crane. So they need to make sure that Chaz is not getting drinks. Xynthius is going to do this by standing as close to him as possible, currently right on top of his character, pretty much. Xynthius needs to keep an eye on Chaz, chase him around the map while avoiding crowd control himself. That is his main objective in this fight, but now he's exposed to center field. Chaz knows that Xynthius needs to do this, so he brings him into midfield. That then sets up Raikou or Swapsy to crowd control him. Then they can get some counter pressure. Currently a Maledict attack here onto Raikou. Would have liked to see a bit better coordination. It seems like Grmbl are activating them one by one, and it's very easy as a healer to deal with that Maledict trinket by simply dispelling it if you go one by one. You have to coordinate all three together for a very big push, especially before dampening. Maybe later in dampening when the healer is out of mana, you no longer need to do that. Or perhaps if they're separating them one by one, dispel is a pretty expensive ability for a healer, so they could actually run Chaz out of mana. Beautiful Ring of Peace. Xynthia doing a great job babysitting Chaz, but Raikou now doing a good job punishing that extension. Do they have enough damage to counter pressure is the question. Voltarius doesn't have cooldowns for 21 more seconds. If Swapsy can get out a ton of damage here, doesn't look like they have it available. Xynthia's now trying to chase down Chaz as they push for an Ice Block on Raikou. The strategy so far looks good for Grmbl. If they can deny the drinks moving forward, this potential for Grmbl to take this to a game five.
Yeah, Raikou, though, trading out that Ice Block, allowing Chaz to sit down and regenerate a lot of mana, has a slight lead, but I don't think he'll be able to keep that lead for very long, especially with the amount of pressure Volkovich and Voltarix have found. Full Hex on Xynthius. Voltarix still in a decent amount of trouble, has to trade out the Trinket, as well as his Touch of Karma. Now very vulnerable, doesn't have any defensives left. Luckily, the Fortifying Brew did just come up. Chaz with the Iron Bark denies a kill. Raikou looking to get really aggressive with his Icy Veins. Interrupt on Xynthius, and still, Grmbl could be in some trouble here.
I mean, it's Raikou who's in trouble. That's a second Ice Block, only at 17% dampening. There's a significant mana lead for Grmbl. Everything is actually looking better and better for them. Their initial push put them far behind, but they just survived and played defensive to reset some of their cooldowns, and now they're actually making well-coordinated pushes towards Raikou. So he will not have another Ice Block for at least 4 minutes. He cannot immune damage. Chaz needs to manage his mana very effectively, because if he goes for a drink, I can only imagine that Grmbl should just simply run Raikou into the ground. Chaz has nothing to trade if he tries to make that move. Swapsy and Raikou are going to have to coordinate together to stall out the team of Grmbl, set Chaz up for a drink if they want a late game kill on Volkovich. Volkovich using Death Grip, he's babysitting Chaz. He's the most durable target on his team right now with the most defensive cooldowns. So Volkovich needs to play on point here to stop Chaz from drinking. but they could just make a push instead while he is looking for it. Not able to find it. Raikou falls more behind, forced to now polymorph up Volkovich. Voltari is slightly overextended, but Xynthius is right beside him now at this point, so they are going to stabilize. They can go for an all-in push. Grmbl can set up to win here with some good coordinated maladies, but Raikou looks to get the reversal. Beautiful counterspell, well-timed lightning lasso. Good polymorph follow-up by Raikou. Crowd control is sick here for Method Black, but there's just no damage to back it up, and Raikou is falling behind. One Maledict. Do they have a second? They need to coordinate them together for the big push, but they're just not. Now Voltarius is feeling the heat as he's overextended, and Swapsy is tearing in. They prematurely trade Touch of Karma to redirect all of Swapsy's bursts into Raikou. There is no defense for Raikou. If they can stay on target and put him down, they need to try and abort this situation. They've dropped the Frozen Orb, Cone of Cold Snare. Raikou is trying to get distance away, but it's so difficult. Finally finding a little bit of space to breathe. Chaz is trying to sneak away for a drink. Now it's all eyes on Raikou. Are they going to race the drink? Ring of Peace denies the drink, but Volkovich is under fire in midfield. As it's a race to the finish, both teams will become increasingly exposed as dampening ramps up.
Yeah, Raikou, though, he's in so much trouble. There's no defense for Method Black. And this is the Stormwind and Fire coming in from Voltariax. Nice Cyclone coming in from Chaz. Raikou still just holding on for dear life. Still has 2 minutes before that ice block comes back up. And Chaz, I don't know if he has enough mana to sustain this, especially at 30% dampening. I really want to see Grmbl just stick on target. They have so many defensive cooldowns they can rotate through to stick on Raikou, deny his damage, keep Chaz healing him. There's the Iron Bark, and after the Iron Bark fades onto Raikou, they need to go for that final push, the final nail in the coffin. Voltaric, stay on target, trade out your Diffuse, trade out your Fortifying Brew, everything you can to take down Raikou, because this is Grumble's moment to tie up the series.
Grmbl are almost at the end of Method Black's maze. One more big push, and they can take victory. Temporal Shield now out of the way. Raikou low on health. Chaz completely tapped on mana. Damage looks good. They've stunlocked Raikou. How much more can he take? He's going to drop Icy Veins and try and counter pressure. They need to get a kill on Volkovich in this stunlock. They've got one more second to do it. They don't get it. Volkovich will survive, but maybe not. Still damage to follow it up. Volkovich is slow. Xynthius makes the trade, and this is what becomes interesting deeper into dampening, is that the Death Knight is so much more exposed and vulnerable to the damage. They're desperately trying to race for a kill. I would almost love to see Xynthius just trinket this Hex and get aggressive for his team, add a bit of extra damage with his Rising Sun Kick. They just need a tad bit more to take Raikou out here. Can Grmbl possibly have the comeback, the reverse sweep?
Raikou's
in trouble. Temporal Shield about to go. He needs one more second for that to heal him, but no! Grmbl are going to do it. Take Method Black to a game five and potentially eliminate them from the tournament on their best map.
Raikou's getting, he's getting tunneled down from start to finish. His opportunity to actually get casted damage is really low, but he's opting to use Tunnel of Ice and Flash Freeze, and these are traits that really buff your damage if you can cast out Frostbolts. But with how limited he is, I'm wondering if there's better Azeroth traits he could be running.
Yeah, he could definitely be running some more instant damage-based Azeroth traits, maybe something along the lines of Glacial Assault, and maybe one Battlefield Focus, something like that. It could potentially be a better choice. Tunnel of Ice, you don't really get too much value unless you're frostbolting the same target over and over again. And it's really meaningless damage at this point in the game, because the Death Knight is going to outheal it very easily. The healer is also going to outheal it without losing too much mana.
Yeah.
I was going to say, if you're a healer at home wondering how Xynthius is managing to do this, if you've been having a difficult time on your Mistweaver Monk, one Azeroth trait in particular for them to pick up is Burst of Life, which then reduces the cooldown of your Life Cocoon by 20 seconds. And that's a lot of time to take off of the clock. When you pair that with the Honor Talent Chrysalis, reducing it even further, you can access that Life Cocoon powerful shield quite often and make good trades with it. And that is how Xynthius can extend these games long enough for his team to survive. He wants to predict crowd control, activate that Life Cocoon shield to absorb all the damage right before the crowd control is initiated, denying it entirely. We see Grmbl getting a bit aggressive here with crowd control onto Chaz. Raikou and Swapsy both invasively maneuvering this attack, though, really denying the reconnects. Maybe a couple of seconds of uptime, but that may not be enough. Voltarius decides that he's just going to stay on target, trying to force an ice block here early on. Although the longer he stays inside that maze, the more dangerous it gets, so he's just going to immediately back off. Xynthius has been locked out of the fight for an extended period of time. Volkovich, on the other hand, does not care. He's just going to keep attacking through, trade out all this damage for Deathstrike, and allow Xynthius to get out of crowd control.
Yeah, and there is the threat from Raikou. He dropped the Frozen Orb, Comet Storm, Ice Nova. This is well Voltaireous. He's not scared anymore. He can charge in. He knows he's going to be making better trades than Raikou can really provide. Frozen Orb does get dropped out once again. Raikou doing a good job making sure Blizzard is down, so that slowly but surely resets the cooldown of Frozen Orb every time it hits a target. So if you can get a high-value Blizzard, drop it on Storm Earth and Fire, the Death Knight, as well as the Windwalker Monk, all the ghouls, that allows you to get these Frozen Orb resets relatively quickly, and that's going to be the most significant damage that Raikou really has available.
We do see all three members of Grmbl making a push here. Chaz may struggle to heal through it, trading out Iron Bark a tad bit late there and now having to overlap, but they will survive. Method Black's turn to attack. Voltaireous portaling out of the fight and avoiding it, now allowing Volkovich to be that damage sponge out in midfield, just counteracting everything with Deathstrike and easily stabilizing as Xynthius sits through an extended crowd control chain. But now that Volkovich can't connect to a target, he does have to trade anti-magic shield, absorbing huge hits. That forces Swapsy and Raikou to switch targets again, going after Voltaireous. But with Xynthius no longer locked down on crowd control, he should be able to deal with this. Actually opts to use Life Cocoon, soaking up all that Frozen Orb damage. Very good timing there, that Frozen Orb, the giant ball spinning with red ice. Life Cocoon trades for that very easily. Now they can stay aggressive and try and get an ice block, but just not finding it. Now, once again, Voltaireous is deep into Method Black's maze. He's trying to stay out in center field and go for an ice block, but the longer he spends out here, the more dangerous it gets. Maledict's committed here as well, forcing Voltaireous to trade Touch of Karma, as well as Xynthius's Gladiator's Medallion, a critical defense overlap on the side of Grmbl, and an opportunity for Method Black.
Yeah, Method Black, I could tell by the way they're playing this game, they're being a little bit more patient. Chaz isn't opting to trade out that Iron Bark. They're making Grmbl work for these defensive cooldowns a little bit longer, which keeps them in the maze, so to speak, a little bit longer, which allows them to get that counter pressure they need onto Voltaireous and Volkovich, forcing out these low cooldown trades from the Touch of Karma as well as the Diffuse Magic. And if they can do that more frequently, be a little bit greedier with their defensives, then they can ultimately pull out a lot more cooldowns. But Raikou getting really low. Touch of Death gets activated.
Oh, it's
Raikou
game five!
Bursted down. A lot of pressure on him. Doesn't want to throw away the game once again. Does have the Ice Block available. Full Polymorph now secured on Xynthius, but he managed to land the Life Cocoon. They shred through it immediately. Voltaireous rolls away, realizing he could be in some trouble, but there's so much on the line here for Method Black. They've won the last two tournaments, now in the lower bracket. Grmbl coming in from basically nowhere. They could potentially just eliminate them right away.
Chaz, though, kept a level head, reset his mana, and now Voltaireous on the back foot, exposed in center field. Volkovich drops the shield to protect Voltaireous, but they can still squeeze in a tiny bit of damage, maybe enough to take him out. Full Polymorph. Voltaireous on the run. He needs at least 12 more seconds. He's trying to buy that with a couple of Vivifies. Good backup by Volkovich in that position. Volkovich was definitely MVP during these seconds, which would have otherwise been Voltaireous's life. Definitely good teamwork there on the side of Grmbl as they battle it out in game five, but they lost that mana advantage due to Chaz sneaking away and getting a drink, even despite all of the pressure thrown at Raikou. Now Voltaireous in the back foot. Once again, Life Cocoon trading for that Frozen Orb. Good trade by Xynthius, but now he's exposed in center field. Swapsy makes the swap. He's looking to drop Xynthius here in game five. Tons of damage, but Fortified Brew is going to be enough. He gets cycloned at low health. Can they set up any damage off this? They've already used the Frozen Orb. They don't have the Stormkeeper. I don't think they have the damage to take Xynthius out. He's going to make a getaway around the corner. Method Black are now forced to switch targets, but later on in the match, if Xynthius is caught like that, it's going to be it for them in the tournament.
Yeah, there's a beautiful cyclone on the Thunder Focus T from Xynthius denying that Ore Mastery heal. Chaz doing an excellent job. Voltaireous has to trade out the Touch of Karma. Xynthius moving in into a Polymorph. Unfortunately, it was diminishing returns. Xynthius with no trinket. Voltaireous in a lot of trouble. Might have to portal away. Raikou looking to get aggressive with his Icy Veins, trying to counter pressure this melee cleave as much as he can. Forces Voltaireous and Grmbl to retreat. But still, Volkovich able to sit out there, continuing some pressure onto Raikou. Chaz sitting down for a drink. If he can reset his mana, this is looking good. Ring of Peace misses. Chaz doing a good job escaping, and that's basically a full reset for Method Black.
Yeah, Chaz is doing a much better job here on Ashermain's Fall than Tolvaron of resetting his mana. They know that Voltaireous and Xynthius are scared. They do not have the defensive cooldowns required to survive an attack and a push, so they're pinned down at the pillar. While they're pinned, Chaz needs to sneak away, and he has been, to make sure that his mana stays ahead of Xynthius for a late game kill onto Volkovich. But now Swapsy gets gripped in as we see Grmbl trying to mix it up, not ultimately able to get get a kill or really any sort of significant cooldowns from Swapsy. Now they are in trouble. Good Frost Nova coordination with that Lightning Lasso to try and pin them out of range of interrupting Swapsy, but Vukovic had its Mind Freeze available to deny the attack. Now we see a Maledict play here by Method Black, but Xynthius here used Life Cocoon. He saw Cyclone being casted, activated Life Cocoon on his teammate right before he was going to be crowd controlled. That shield absorbed all of the damage while he was unable to heal. That was a nice play by Xynthius. Now they're trying to get aggressive here towards Raikou. At 13% dampening, this is when they need to make a triple Maledict play. This is when they have to start forcing Ice Blocks if they want to get a kill.
Yeah, Xynthius caught into the full Hex. Good denial by Swapsy. Chaz is in that incapacitate. Certainly Xynthius was looking for the leg sweep, but Swapsy was able to shut that down. 15% dampening. Volterix midfield with the Touch of Death rolling. Raikou gets bursted down. Do they have the damage? There's the full leg sweep. Ironbark gets used out by Chaz, denying a lot of this damage, but they might be able to just push through it. Volterix trades out the Diffuse Magic. Still has the Touch of Karma. Might have to use that as well as Raikou's looking to counter pressure. Volterix gets low. There's the Touch of Karma. They need to avoid attacking it as much as possible. Possible because Raikou, this redirected damage could be very scary with no temporal shield, with no Ironbark. Volterix doesn't want to be caught in center field for too long. Both of these players playing a little bit risky. Raikou getting lower, looking for the polymorph denial on some of this damage. Anti-magic zone gets dropped right on top of Raikou, and that's going to allow Volterix and Vukovic maximum uptime where they are not afraid of this Frost Mage.
Trading defense for more offense to try and pin down the objective, which is Ice Block, but ultimately no Maledict coordination on the side of Grmbl, and this has been the weakness of them throughout this entire series. If they had proper Maledict coordination, they would more than easily take an Ice Block from Raikou in that position, but they just don't have the coordination. And Method Black advance, getting a significant lead moving forward as a result. Deeper into dampening, Vukovic is a viable target, and then all three members will be in danger for the team of Grmbl, whereas Chaz can focus almost entirely on healing Raikou. Committing his resources to one player is a lot more taxing than Xynthius having to keep his eyes open for his entire team potentially going down. And on match point, the pressure is simply just at its maximum. You're facing elimination. You lose this game, you're out of the cup, you lose the opportunity to earn more points. Method Black, the top point earner, that would be devastating for them for the rest of the season, as it could be a race to the finish here against that temporal shield. Denies the kill. Raikou stays alive. Volterius running out of cooldowns. Needs 5 more seconds on that Touch of Karma. Xynthius now at a significant mana disadvantage. Everything snowballing out of control for Grmbl.
Yeah, things are very scary for Grmbl. Raikou sitting on both of his Ice Blocks. Haven't had to use one this entire game. Now Volterix finally reconnecting. Icy Veins does get used. Volterix trades out the Touch of Karma, immediately looking to make an offensive push. Xynthius's mana is not doing well. Chaz has been doing such a good job in this game, sitting down for the drinks. Lightning Lasso on Volterix as he gets a little bit lower, forced to retreat to the pillar once again. Oh. Maledict gets traded out by Raikou, looking for the Ray of Frost. An immediate interrupt from a Mind Freeze of Vukovic. That does slow down some of Raikou's damage, and ultimately Grmbl will survive, but at the expense of basically everything. You can look, Xynthius, no defensive cooldowns left, no trinket. Volterix, nothing left as well. Method Black, they could push in here and try to close out this game.
I think that they should at this point. They're ahead on mana, they're ahead on cooldowns. They can make an aggressive trade and close the match out at 30% dampening. Swapsy secures crowd control into two members, hard carrying the team on his back at this point. If Raikou gets in line of sight, it's likely to be curtains for Volterius. Vukovic once again MVP anti-magic zone. The only thing keeping Volterius alive is that purple shield activated by Vukovic. It appears to be enough for now, but now Volterius gets cycloned at low health. This cyclone denies incoming healing as well as damage. Xynthius tries to time some heals right at the end of it, but he opens himself up to counterspell. Raikou not able to land it. Now they switch their attention to Vukovic. Deep into dampening, he has to be careful about this overextension. Grmbl, they're against the wall. They don't have much left in terms of decisions. They're all out of mana. They don't have any ice blocks. They have to start making something happen at this point. They have to make risky moves. It's game five. It's all or nothing.
Yet Life Cocoon gets used on Volterix, one of the last lines of defense. Still, they shred through it. Raikou under a little bit of assault. Maledict flying in from Grmbl. Volterix getting low. Trades out the Touch of Karma, but now Grmbl, nothing left. Beautiful cyclone from Chaz. If they can get any crowd control on Xynthius, if Raikou can somehow sneak in a polymorph, Volterix could easily fall in this situation. Raikou needs to be careful. There's still a thin line between life and death. As Volterix uses his Fist of Fury, Raikou has to trade out Temporal Shield, overlapped with Ice Block, and that's not a great spot for Method Black.
Chaz snuck away and regenerated some mana. He's got a huge advantage in that regard. Method Black are still in a good position to win, but you just can't count Grmbl out. If they can get one big wave, one big push, one all in, they could potentially knock the top point earners of Europe, Method Black, out of the tournament. They go for a three-man push. They have to crush him through Ironbark. Xynthius gets hexed. He can't follow up with any burst. Voltarius commits his Touch of Death, his highest hitting attack, but he gets completely denied on it. They have to stay on target, but they're forced to run. They can't pin Raikou down. Now Volkovich is exposed in center field, taking a huge exchange of damage. That anti-magic shield just gets shredded through by Method Black at 42% dampening. There's no mana left in the tank for Xynthius. He's locked out of the game in a Cyclone. Voltarius makes the trade with that fortified brew, but even that may not be enough at 42% dampening. Can they get the second ice block from Raikou? He cannot afford to not trade if he's greedy in this position, as we did see a game go in favor of Grmbl due to Raikou's greed. Can Method Black stay level-headed here? They've secured such a huge lead throughout this match. It would be a throwaway to ultimately go down, but the game is maybe slipping out of their hands. Raikou tries to get control, positioning that Blizzard on top of himself, so when the team rolls in, they are going to get snared up. They've isolated Voltarius, but he was able to sneak in Touch of Karma right before Xynthius got crowd-controlled. The defensive cooldowns are perfectly traded by Grmbl to sustain themselves on basically nothing. Chaz sits down for a drink once again to just secure that mana advantage. Gets denied by Voltarius. Frozen Orb gets placed. Volkovich is in trouble here at 47% damage. Now Voltarius gets swapped to. He trades Diffuse. Can they get the second ice block with this push?
No.
Maledix into the Temporal Shield. All three members. This is the coordination I wanted to see from the team of Grmbl. That nets them an overlap of cooldowns. If they can somehow survive off the back of it, they've got an opening, but Swapsy is trying to close that opening as quickly as possible. Not able to find it. They switch their attention back to Volkovich. There's still no mana left for Xynthius. Volkovich has to keep himself alive. Maybe they go for an anti-magic zone push, and they do. Raikou needs to get out of this shield as soon as possible, but he doesn't have a blink. He can't move. He's pinned down. Method Black might be going home.
Yeah, Raikou's still on the run. Chaz was able to sit down for a big drink, but that incapacitate from Voltarix will slow some of that healing down. Raikou in a great position. Voltarix with really nothing left. Xynthius, no defensive cooldowns. Method Black have all the tools they need to close out this game, but Grmbl can still make an offensive push if they can just survive a little bit longer. Full stun on Raikou. Touch of Death available. Fortifying Brew. Can they take him down? Full Polymorph on Xynthius, and ultimately Method Black survives, staying alive in this tournament.
Oh, you see, just trying to get out those. And we saw Feed versus the Fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.